Good morning. I just have two announcements today. The first one is a reminder that Nancy is selling land of certain tickets in the far after church services. I believe it costs us $6 per hoagie. And the other one is congratulations to all the graduates of the United Lutheran Seminary. Commencement was held virtually this past Friday. And a special congratulations to Justin Taylor Marks upon receiving his Master's of Divinity degree. And thank you to Justin's wife Sarah and his families for supporting him on his journey. We pray for God's blessing as they enter this new chapter in their lives.
Please stand as you're. We begin our service in the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Alleluia. Christ is risen.
Christ is risen indeed. Alleluia.
Refreshed by the resurrection life we share in Christ, let us give thanks for the gift of baptism. We thank you, risen Christ. For these waters where you make us new, leading us from death to life, from tears to joy, we bless you, risen Christ, that your Spirit comes to us in the grace-filled waters of the earth, like rains of our thirsting earth, and like streams that revive our souls, like cups of cold water shared with strangers. Breathe your peace on your church when we hide in fear. Lord, bless with your mercy and forgiveness. Bless us and companions on our journey as we share your life. Make us one with risen Christ. Cleanse our hearts. Shower us with life as you be given all praise. In the Holy Spirit, in glory of God, now and forever. Amen.
This will be pray to the Lord. Help, save, comfort, and defend us, gracious Lord.
Transform us by your truth, and give us language to proclaim your gospel. Through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen.
A reading from Acts. When the day of Pentecost had come, the apostles were all together in one place. And suddenly from heaven, there came a sound like the rush of a violent wind, and it filled the entire house where they were sitting. Divided tongues, as of fire, appeared among them, and a tongue rested on each of them. All of them were filled with the Holy Spirit, and began to speak in other languages as the Spirit gave them ability. Now there were devout Jews from every nation under heaven living in Jerusalem. And at the sound, the crowd gathered and was bewildered, because each one heard them speaking in the native language of each. Amazed and astonished, they asked, "Are not all those who are speaking Galileans? And how is it that we hear, each of us, in our own native languages? Parthians, Medes, Elamites, and residents of Mesopotamia, Judea and Cappadocia, Pontus and Asia, Phrygia and Pamphylia, Egypt and the parts of Libya belonging to Cyrene, and visitors from Rome, both Jews and proselytes, Cretans and Arabs, in our own languages we hear them speaking about God's deeds of power. All were amazed and perplexed, saying to one another, 'What does this mean?' But others sneered and said, 'They are filled with new wine.' But Peter, standing with the 11, raised his voice and addressed them, 'Men of Judea and all who live in Jerusalem, let this be known to you and listen to what I say. Indeed, these are not drunk as you suppose, for it is only 9 o'clock in the morning. No, this was spoken through the prophet Joel. In the last days it will be, God declares, that I pour out my spirit upon all flesh, and your sons and your daughters shall prophesy, and your young men shall see visions, and your old men shall dream dreams. even upon my slaves, both men and women. In those days, I will pour out my spirit, and they will prophesy. And I will show portents in the heavens above, and signs on the earth below, blood and fire and smoky mist. The sun shall return to darkness, and the moon to blood. And before the coming of the Lord's great and glorious day, then everyone who calls on the name of the Lord shall be saved. The word of the Lord. The Psalms go responsibly. How manifold are your works, O Lord. In wisdom you have made them all. The earth is full of your creatures. There go the ships to and fro, and the Leviathan which you made for the sport of it. You give it to them, they gather it. You open your hand, and they are filled with good things. You send forth your spirit, and they are created. And so you renew the face of the earth. You look at the earth and it trembles. You touch the mountains and they smoke. May these words of mine please God. I will rejoice in the Lord.
Bless the Lord and my soul.
A reading from Romans. We know that the whole creation has been groaning in labor pains until now. And not only the creation, but we ourselves, who have the first fruits of the Spirit, groan inwardly while we wait for adoption, the redemption of our bodies. For in hope we were saved. Now that it is seen is not hope. Now hope that is seen is not hope. For who hopes for what is seen? Well, if we hope for what we do not see, we wait for it with patience. Likewise, the Spirit helps us in our weakness, for we do not know how to pray as we ought, but that very Spirit intercedes with signs too deep for words. And God, who searches the heart, knows what is the mind of the Spirit, because the Spirit intercedes for the saints according to the will of God. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Holy Gospel according to St. John. Jesus said, when the Advocate comes, whom will I send to you from the Father? The Spirit of truth who comes from the Father, he will testify on my behalf. You also are to testify because you have not been with me from the beginning. I did not say these things to you from the beginning because I was with you. But now I am going to him who sent me. Yet none of you asked me, where are you going? But because I have said these things to you, sorrow has filled your hearts. Nevertheless, I tell you the truth. It is to your advantage that I go away. For if I do not go away, the Advocate will not come to you. But if I go, I will send him to you. And when he comes, he will prove the world wrong about sin and righteousness and judgment, about sin, because they do not believe in me, about righteousness, because I am going to the Father and you will see me no longer, about judgment, because the ruler of this world has been condemned. I still have many things to say to you, but you cannot bear them now. When the Spirit of truth comes, he will guide you into all the truth, for he will not speak on his own, but will speak whatever he hears. And he will declare to you the things that are to come. He will glorify me, because he will take what is mine and declare it to you. All that the Father has is mine. For this reason, I said that you will take what is mine and declare it to you. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, O Christ.
The Holy Spirit does not usually act in ways that we expect. This week, I visited a patient in the hospital, and this patient is a cancer patient. A month ago, she found out that she has stage 4 pancreatic cancer. She was going to die. I quickly realized the importance in her voice and decided that I would sit down. I pulled up a chair and asked if it's okay if I sit down with you. The patient slowly responded, saying, "Yes." I sat down and scooted a little closer. I asked, "How are you doing with that information?" She responded that she does not know. This cancer diagnosis seemed to still be new information to her. It seems as though she might still be numb. At this point, she got quiet. I felt the pressure to say something. It felt like a good moment to affirm her or give her a source of hope. It was a good moment to convey something, anything, but I didn't. I let the quiet fill the space. I didn't say anything, but I just sat with her in silence. I let the patient fill the silence with whatever she needed to say. She then told me about how her daughter-in-law called her not but 2 days after she got out of the hospital. The daughter-in-law said, "Sorry about your mom," over the phone call. The patient had no idea that her mother had died when she was in the hospital and when she found out that she had cancer. It seems like her life had just been getting worse and worse, and she did not know how to handle it. More silence. I asked the clarification questions and reflected on what she said back to her. I was not sure how to fill the silence with her, giving her disheartening story. I just sat there in the silence with her, giving her the opportunity to feel through her emotions and the time to reflect verbally on what has been going on in her life. Today is Pentecost Sunday. Do you know what that means? It's all about the Holy Spirit. Whenever we read the word Spirit in the Bible, it comes from the Greek word pneumatos. And pneumatos is best translated as spirit, wind, or breath. This word comes up a lot when we see God breathing life onto the earth. And we see it in Genesis when God breathes life onto the earth. We see it when Jesus was born and was baptized by the Holy Spirit. And we see it in our text today when God shows God's presence in the early church in Acts. When we find this word in Greek, the scholars who translate the Bible have no idea if it means breath, wind, or spirit. So they usually just pick whichever one they like. So when we look into the different Bible translation, this word can be whatever, based on whatever the translator likes best. But today, the Holy Spirit shows her presence to all the people of God. And the Holy Spirit does not usually act in the ways that we expect. As Lori Beth Jones writes, "Wind is swift, uplifting, whirling, motion-oriented, and refreshing. It can be silent or howling, and in itself is invisible. It is a mysterious, unpredictable, energetic, and global. It is cleansing, musical, electric, haunting, sweeping, caressing, and scent-bearing. Wind warms, cools, soothes, and pollinates. It inspires, literally giving breath to everything that moves. Winds can penetrate through cracks in walls and fabric. It is persuasive and enigmatic. It can whisper and caress and tease and play. It can lift up kites and dash down buildings. It supports butterflies and hummingbirds and can sweep the old away in a single breath. That's an excerpt from a book called The Four Elements of Success. And Miss Jones describes the personality of wind in that book. Wind can be a subtle whisper in your ear, or it can be a tornado running across the land. It can find its way through the smallest cracks, and it cannot be stopped. Wind is always present and cannot be removed from the room. Winds can be violent and destructive, or it can be silent and refreshing. Wind is the breath of God. It is the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit is all of these things in the Bible. Today we read about some different ways that the Holy Spirit acts in the world. Today we see the Holy Spirit descend on the disciples of Jesus and give them the ability to speak in other languages. It says, the Holy Spirit comes down like tongues of fire and bestows gifts and leaves the people amazed and astonished. In Romans, we read about how the Holy Spirit helps us in our weaknesses. In John, we find Jesus telling us that he will send the Holy Spirit to guide us in all truth. The Holy Spirit acts differently in each one of these situations. But one thing is certain. The Holy Spirit does not usually act in ways that we expect. In Acts, the Holy Spirit acts in a violent manner. She blows in like a rush of violent wind from heaven. Divided tongues as a fire appeared and a tongue rested on each person. That sounds like something for one of my nightmares. All of them were filled with the Holy Spirit and began to speak in other languages. That doesn't sound like the organization of God to me. It sounds like going to a noisy bar that no one can hear anything at. It sounds like a mess. It sounds like the Holy Spirit came into Jerusalem and just kind of like turned everything upside down. Your sons and daughters shall prophesy, but God, only old people prophesy. Your young men shall see visions. Visions are not something that young men do. Your old men shall dream dreams. Silly God, dreams are only for kids. Even upon my slaves, both men and women, and they shall prophesy. But God, aren't there more important people in our lives than slaves that we can learn your prophecies from? You will show portents in the heaven above and signs below. Blood, fire, and smoky mist. Jeez, God, why are you doing something so violent? The sun shall be turned to darkness and the moon to blood. That sounds pleasant. To me, it sounds like the Holy Spirit is going to make a mess. Well, yes, because the breath of God does not always act in ways that we expect. The Holy Spirit did not act in the way that I expected when I was visiting with this patient in the hospital either. When I left the room, she thanked me and told me that my visit helped her to think through some of the things that she had struggled with. But what were they? You told me about your stage 4 cancer and the death of your mother. But what about that were you struggling with? Did you come to some level of a conclusion or a place of peace in your situation? Where was it? And where are you? And how did I help you? All I did was sat here in the silence with you. I did not ask any questions. I did not give you any words of hope. I did not say anything of value. I was just silent. Did I really do anything? I don't think I was helpful, but the Holy Spirit did something that I did not expect. The wind of God swooped in and comforted her in her silence. The breath of God was a warm, refreshing wind that comforted her in her distress. It wasn't me. The Holy Spirit never responds how we expect. In Acts, we see the Holy Spirit blow through Jerusalem like a hurricane. In an instant, everyone knew that the Holy Spirit was present with them. When I was in the hospital, the Holy Spirit blew through a little bit more quietly. She interceded with sighs too deep for words and filled the silence with a soft, comforting presence. And at that moment, both of us knew that the Holy Spirit was there, comforting this stage 4 pancreatic cancer patient who had just lost her mom not but a month ago as well. The Holy Spirit can blow in and flip over tables in a heartbeat. She can blow everything away and replace the old with nothingness. Or she can be present with us in the silence and give us a source of comfort in our deepest moments of despair. We may not always know how the Holy Spirit will blow us, but one thing is for sure. The Holy Spirit will always be present for us and guide us through our lives to give us the breath of God so that we can keep on living in God. Amen. church, let us profess our faith using the words of the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, God's only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven. He is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. The peace of our Lord Jesus Christ be with you all.
And also with you.
Please share a sign of that peace with one another. In distance.
Thank you.
Alive in the risen Christ by the power of the Holy Spirit, we bring our prayers before God, who promises to hear us and answer us in steadfast love.
Gracious God, you give the Holy Spirit to your church, filling it with many and varied gifts. In the church throughout the world, strengthen us in our visioning and dreaming, that it may discover anew the Spirit's creative work. Hear us, O God. God of life, your mighty works are too numerous to count. The earth is full of your creatures, living things both great and small. Open your hand and give them the necessities of this life. Send your flesh spirit over the face, your fresh spirit over the face of the earth. Hear us, O God. God of the nations, at the sound of the rushing wind, people speaking different languages, proclaimed and heard together your deeds of power. Fill the leaders of nations with your Holy Spirit, so that they exercise your gracious will in the lives of the people. Hear us, O God. God of faithfulness, you tend to the needs of your people, even the size of our hearts. Hear those who cry out to you in distress. Restore to wholeness all who are in any need this day, especially to those who name in our hearts or out loud. Hear us, O God. God of love, fill this congregation with gratitude for the gifts that we have received from you. Renew our ministries, heal our divisions, and open us to the needs of our neighbors. Hear us, O God. God of hope, those who have died in you raise their eternal song of praise. We give you thanks for the many gifts of your people and rejoice in the witness of your saints. Hear us, O God. In the hope of new life in Christ, we raise our prayers to you, trusting in your never-ending goodness and mercy through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
In our service with thanksgiving of the Lord. Let us pray. Praise and thanks to you, Holy God, for by your word you made all things. You spoke light into darkness, called forth beauty from chaos, and brought life into being. For your word of life, O God. By your word you called your people Israel to tell of your wonderful gifts, freedom from captivity, water on a desert journey, a pathway home from exile, wisdom for life with you, for your word of life, O God. Through Jesus, your word made flesh, you speak to us and call us to witness, forgiveness through the cross, life to those consumed by death, the way of your self-giving love, for your word of life, O God. Send your spirit of truth, O God. Rekindle your gifts within us. Renew our faith, increase our hope, and deepen our love. For the sake of the world and me, faithful to your word, O God, draw near to all who call on you. Through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord, to whom with you and the Holy Spirit be honor and glory forever and ever.
Amen.
Lord, remember us in your kingdom and teach us to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory. Receive now the blessing. May the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord's face shine on you and be gracious to you. May the Lord look upon you with favor and give you peace.
Thank you.
Alleluia. Christ is risen.
Christ is risen indeed. Alleluia.
Go in peace. Share the good news. Alleluia.
Thanks be to God. Alleluia.